a big thank you to all of them who told me that you cannot make it into Bollywood. You should only be a television actress. I was criticized for my weight. The reason why I am here today is also because of Vidya ma'am.
Hello everyone. Steve Jobs once said, if you're working on something that you really care about, you don't have to be pushed. Your vision pulls you, and our guest today has that vision. You've seen her in Batla House, you've seen her in Super 30, and there's lots more coming up, but for now, she's here on Pink Villa. Hi Mrunal, welcome to Pink Villa for our special Women's Day edition called Woman Up.
Thank you.
Yes.
Happy to be here.
You know, you made a very successful transition from TV to films. Mm-hmm. And it is usually said that it's not an easy transition, you know, especially when you've made a space for yourself in TV and then you go to films. People, you know, I'm sure there must be people around you who must have said, mat karo, why? Mm-hmm. It's a very settled space already. Why do you want to experiment? Tell me, you know, about this journey from TV to films. Did you face these kind of barriers, these questions?
Yeah, of course I did, but I must say through this platform, I actually want to say thank you to all the people who said that, because if they wouldn't have said all those, if they wouldn't have passed those comments, I wouldn't be here sitting in front of you. So a big thank you to all of them who told me that you cannot make it into Bollywood. You should only be a television actress. But I'm happy where I am, and actually that's how I got motivated. So I took it in a very positive way.
But did you hear that a lot, and was it discouraging at some point?
It wasn't too much, but there were times where I used to go for film auditions and they would say that this is not meant for you. And then I would still be like, ek audition leke rakh do. Although there was a lot of criticism, but I think that was something that kept me moving.
What were these criticisms?
They said that you have a very television face, you're only good for television, anyway you have that stain, you know, like you are a television actor now, you can't be a Bollywood. If you wanted to be into acting, you should have just straight away gone to Bollywood.
Yeah.
Also there was a stereotype mentality where people were like, television actors cannot do that transition.
Sure.
But I just wanted to break it, and I just felt like films were something that I was meant for, and I didn't stop.
What keeps you motivated saying, I have to turn blind eye to all these discouragements and keep going?
Honestly, when Love Sonia released, people only offered me those gaon wali, those kind of roles. But I had to make sure that I did not take up those roles, because I felt like I will be stereotyped. I was criticized for my weight lot of times, but I feel that was for good. You know, as an actor, I think I need to be fit. I need to transform my body, and that particular role needed me to lose that kind of weight. So I just took it in a positive way.
But you know, unfortunately, that's also the scene that most women have to go through these criticisms.
Yeah,
and
they do.
You know, men
body shaming to bahut hota hai. Men also, I have so many friends, poor boys, they have to go like so many, there's so much stuff that they have to go through. Like actors especially, six pack abs hone hi chahiye, action aana hi chahiye.
Sure.
So yeah, everybody goes through criticism, not just women.
Did you always want to be an actor?
No, I didn't know what I was supposed to be. Until 12th, I wanted to be a dentist. I wanted to do BDS.
Wow.
And I almost got into the college. I got the admission for BDS. Mm-hmm. I prepared for the medical entrance exams, and then later I felt like there's something that I should be doing, and something very creative, different. Definitely not be a doctor. I don't know what I would have done today if I was a doctor. Oh God. But I'm happy.
Sure.
I'm happy I'm an actor.
Do you think Love Sonia was a stepping stone for you?
Yes, of course it was. People had already seen me in television. There's too much drama. Obviously, you don't get to perform. You have to be that character for like crazy number of years. I felt like the first film that I was supposed that I want to be a part of should be an epic film, should be an evergreen film where people would just watch it and be like, you know, we've learned something from Runal, or I want like young actors to come and say that I have studied this film when it comes to performance, like how I studied Smita Patil's film, or you know, many other, like it's really interesting that how Love Sonia changed that image of mine, where people were like, we didn't really recognize you, Mrunal. It's the same Bulbul who performed Sonia. So that was a huge compliment for me.
Sure. You said you studied Smita Patil films.
Yeah, yeah. Like, there are a lot of films that I used to just watch her for the body. I felt like she was way ahead of her time, her performances.
I agree.
I also watched the film called Mandi, and it was nice to see her perform, because I felt never at any scene, I did not feel that she was acting. I just felt like she was just playing the character, and she was just being herself, and her body language, the way she sits, the way she gets up, the way she delivers the dialogue, not necessarily I have to look into your eyes while I say the dialogue. So all these small things, I picked it up from her, and I really adore her.
After doing good work on TV and being, you know, a known face on TV, when you go to films and then you have to audition again, start again from the scratch, is that like a problem?
No, not at all. No? It's a part of your life. You know, that's where the problem is. Now, as an actor, we get a job. It's like how construction, you know, how architect, he designs one building, then moves on to another.
True.
But again, in order to move on, he needs to show his profile, right?
Sure.
Or he needs to show what design is going to set up, or, you know. Similarly with actors, you know, when the moment Love Sonia was done, I had to again start with the audition process. And I feel in India, the audition process is very different.
Sure.
And there is this stigma in actors' mind that, you know, why should I audition? I have become an established actor now. I don't feel like I need to audition. But today, even today, I feel if there is any filmmaker who approaches me and if he thinks that he needs a screen test, I would be really happy to do that, because it just doesn't allow him to understand the character and see vision, like what his vision was.
Sure.
But also allows me to understand whether I am fit for the role or not, or am I like, can I be that character? Can I play that character? So I feel like screen test, let's replace the word audition by screen test.
Sure.
I think screen test should happen.
Screen test should
happen. No matter how big established the actors are. Because sometimes I don't want the director to say ki are yaar galti ho gayi.
Would you ever want to go back to TV? Do something there?
I mean, why not? TV is where I started, and I take immense pride in it. I would love to be like, I used to watch Satyameva Jayate, which Aamir sir had, you know, he featured on a couple of seasons on Star Plus, and I was I used to really look forward to the episodes, because there's something that you would learn, and he did make a lot of difference. TV ka reaches a lot, like people, everybody in, it's pan India, you know, everyone watches television. And if there is anything like Satyameva Jayate coming up, then I would like to be a part of it.
Lovely.
Where I can just change the mentality of the society, or just make this world a better place to live in.
Now, since you have made this transition, and I'm sure you're in a very happy place, whoever is wanting to make this shift and is thinking, and there are people around them also who are saying, mat karo, mat karo, mat karo, what do you want to say to those guys?
Well, just don't listen to anyone. Do what you feel like doing. If you feel like you're deserving, give yourself a chance. People, it's their job to pull you down. It's their job, society's job, to pull all of us down. But just make sure that you give your best, because when you grow old, you will tell yourself that, okay, I at least tried. You won't be guilty ki kaash main karta.
Sure.
So just make sure you don't listen to the people around you. Keep trying, keep auditioning. Audition dene se koi chota nahi ho jata, let me tell you. You only keep becoming better. Rejection you will face, but it's for good. So many films I got rejected for, but I'm happy that it was Love Sonia. I didn't get through. But what is meant to be is meant to be. You can't.
How long was that period of waiting to get a good film?
Waiting, 2016 I got the film. I started in 2012. And the film released in 2018. So if you say 2012 to 2018 was the period for my film to come out.
Do you sometimes get impatient during that time?
No.
No?
Itna 6 saal ruk sakti hu to. I don't think I am. I'm a very calm person.
Do you have an idol yourself?
Vidya Balan, of course. I adore her. She's always smiling. Her smile is so infectious.
That is.
And what a confident woman. I think the reason why I am here today is also because of Vidya ma'am.
Is it?
Because always in my mind, it's like, I was like, if she made it, I can make it too.
Sure.
And always the kind of film that she has chosen, from Kahani to Dirty Picture to, you know, Tumhari Sullu, they all are so different.
Sure.
And female centric. So I'm really happy that she has actually changed Bollywood.
That she has.
Yeah.
What's happening next now? What's on your plate? There's a lot I know.
There's a lot of stuff happening. Peepa is happening, so I'm very excited about Peepa.
It's with Ishan Khattar.
It's with Ishan and Priyanshu.
Uh-huh.
So I'm really looking forward. We will begin shooting next month.
Sure. And you finished shooting for Jersey and Tufan, right?
Yes.
Those are exciting films as well.
They are I'm very excited for them to release. Thanks to COVID, you know, things have just gotten delayed and pushed. But I think 2021 is the year where the audience would get to see like different kind of me. Like they'll see me in Tufan, they will see me in Jersey, they will see me in Aankh Micholi.
Mm.
So all three films are like very different from each other.
Wow, looking forward.
Yes.
So we move to the second segment. It's now the fun round, the game segment.
Okay, I love it.
I'm going to ask you questions about women achievers and women-centric films.
Okay.
Now, these questions are divided into three hints. I'll give you one hint about probably a one achiever or a film, and you have to identify that person or that film from that hint. If you can't, then I move to the second one, which is a simpler one. And if you can't, I move to the third one.
Okay, but just telling the audience, don't have high expectations. I go blank when I'm at the spot.
These are very simple questions.
Okay, let's go.
So my first hint.
Mm-hmm.
This Indian actress rose to prominence after featuring in a Hollywood film, which then bagged multiple Oscars.
Frida Pinto.
Wow. I thought it would take time to reach there.
No, Frida it is.
Who's your co-star also?
She's my very good friend.
You all worked in Love Sonia together.
We worked in Love Sonia.
Are you all still in touch?
Yes, of course. I mean, I have to say thank you to Frida because she helped me all throughout my press junkets, with my interviews. I think if I'm confident about myself, it's probably because of her.
She's a charmer.
She is a charmer.
She's a charmer.
And she's a very intelligent, wise woman, I have
She
met.
Is. And very funny also. Very funny she is. Next question. So, hint number one.
Mm-hmm.
This film released in 2016 and was based on a real life incident which also had a Kapoor connection.
Kapoor connection.
Hmm.
2016,
yes.
Kapoor connection, and it's real life.
Based on a real life incident, yes.
Based on a real life incident. Okay, what's the other hint?
Second hint is Shabana Azmi played the leading lady's mother.
Nirja.
Yes.
Nirja.
It is Nirja.
Ram Adani's film.
Yes.
Sonam.
Yes. Next one. This achiever is the daughter of a well respected filmmaker actress. She's even the recipient of two National Film Awards.
Second hint.
Her last directorial had bagged a Filmfare Award for Best Debut Director. Vikrant Masi and Kalki Koyuklin played important parts in the film.
Vikrant and Kalki.
I'm talking about this actress. So,
actress?
Yeah, who's also the daughter of another filmmaker actress. Very respected one.
Sorry, pass. I'm blank.
I'll give you one more.
Yeah.
She was in Wake Up Sid.
Deepika? No.
No, Wake Up Sid.
Wake Up Sid. Konkana?
Yes.
Konkana!
Konkana Sanjayvaitis. And the last one.
Yes.
This biographical sports drama was directed by Umang Kumar and produced by Sanjay. Yes, Sanjay Leela
Bhansali.
Simple one, na?
Yeah,
it was simple.
Yeah.
You played very well. Thank Woo-hoo! You so much.
Thank you.
Before we end this interview, I really want to tell you you're special, you're important, and keep doing what you're doing because you keep inspiring everyone out there.
Thank you. You made my day, Avinash.
Thank you
so much. If you like this video, please like, share, and subscribe to Pink Villa.